Sometimes, when you're about to fall asleep and you're thinking about the mysteries of the universe, you might drift off and start dreaming of your favorite theoretical physicist. Einstein. You might also wonder about this thing called gravitational waves, just like Einstein did. What the heck are they, anyway? Let's step back for a second. Einstein's theory of general relativity is a grand theory of gravity that unifies two ways of describing the universe, special relativity and the law of universal gravitation. Special relativity, which we have thanks to Einstein, gave us an equation you might be familiar with, E equals mc squared, energy equals mass times the speed of light squared. Special relativity also helped us to understand how light travels in a vacuum, and how the laws of physics work in different frames of reference, which leads to all sorts of craziness, like the twin paradox. That's what happens when you get in a rocket and travel close to the speed of light, and then come back to Earth, and your twin is much older than you. Newton's law of universal gravitation tells us about how bodies in space are attracted to each other in a way that's proportional to their mass and the distance between them. It gave us this familiar equation, force equals mass times acceleration. Special relativity and Newton's law of universal gravitation have been experimentally verified. So general relativity takes both of these ideas and unifies them, describing gravity as a property of space and time. In fact, gravity becomes a geometric property of space and time, which change shape when different masses, energy, and radiation are present. So what are gravitational waves? These are waves or ripples in space-time that move around objects. Experimental verification of gravitational waves would be one more confirmation that our old friend Einstein was right all along with his theory of general relativity. Thanks, Albert.
Bye-bye.